Improv Theater. Improvalooza. Please put your hands together for our host, Marn Shalpa.
Everybody. How are we doing today? Nice. This is night three of Improvapalooza. Can I hear from anybody who has been here for both previous nights? And who's here for the first time right now? Nice. This year's Improvapalooza is mammoth, it is monstrous, it is gargantuan, it is 199 shows long. We've been going, like I said, for 2 days already. By the end of tonight, which will technically be like close to 3 o'clock tomorrow morning, we will be almost halfway through. Almost. Almost. Tonight's lineup is mesmerizing. You have a one-man Western. You have a one-woman movie. You have a Bollywood movie. You have a wet dead girl. And she's dead. She's here for you. Improvapalooza is an experimental smorgasbord of improv. It's been going on here at WIT for 11 years, and it's our chance to try any idea we possibly have that we're like, you know what would be good? About 5 minutes on stage for this idea, right? Maybe not six, but five solid minutes would be really awesome. So that's what's coming at you tonight. My name is Marn Shalpa, I'm the artistic director here at WIT. Our mission is not only performance, but also teaching and bringing improv's ideas to the workplace. So if you have a workplace which is dull and not creative and not collaborative, fuck that. Yeah. Talk to somebody in your training department, or maybe that's you, in which case shame you, and bring WIT at Work in to play with you. Likewise, if you are a dull, uncreative, uncollaborative person, think about taking an improv class just for yourself, right? We've got a great semester of classes starting this fall, and they're enrolling now. That's all I have to say. Just want to make sure you know WIT is a nonprofit. We're a mission-driven organization, so anytime you win the lottery, think about Washington Improv Theater. We do accept lottery donations. Our first act tonight is something that I think the WIT community and really the national improv scene has been crying out for, and that is an all-male team. So,
I'm gonna throw this one open.
Like,
net.
Beer.
Thank you.
Fucking open beer.
Gladys, get in here! Fucking get on the ground and start licking it. Clean the floor. All of you, right now. Now, who is your favorite frat brother? You are. Oh, right now, try to bench press.
Okay.
No. She told me I had to go get the tampons.
What?
I had to go get the tampons.
I had to get tampons for my sister all the time growing up. They would put them in my room.
How did you even know what it was?
My mom is a labor and delivery nurse.
Okay, David, we get it. You're sensitive. You know about women's things. It's fine.
Someone's jealous.
I'm not jealous.
Yeah, you are.
I don't get jealous.
Girls talk to me all the time.
Whatever. They sleep with me all the time.
Yeah.
They're
talking
to you to talk about things before they sleep with him.
So I'm gonna get this.
Not my idea! Say that you can talk to them all you want. When they come into my room, they have sex for way longer than they expected each time.
And then they ask you to buy their tampons.
And they ask for
let's go back to that.
Tara's being crazy. She told me that we've been doing this for long enough now to make it official, and then she started crying when I said no because I have to meet up with Sarah.
Bitch.
Right?
She cried?
She cried.
Oh, I thought you cried.
No, we never cry. We never. No,
that's why I called him a bitch.
Hey, guys, pharmacist over here. Couldn't help it over here. You might want to tell your ladies there's now a birth control pill they can go on where they don't bleed at all.
What?
They have to pay for it on their insurance.
So we don't have to do anything.
No work for us.
You gotta do a little work if you know what I mean.
No.
I don't know what
you
mean.
You don't know what you mean.
Show us what you got.
We gotta see the numbers.
Come
Danny.
On, Danny.
Come on,
not,
you got
2-3 is a fucking shitter, man.
Let's see your shit,
so
Danny.
You.
I am so hungover.
Yeah, it was so much pressure.
Like, all you wanted to do was, like, legit do the work, right? But then,
and they were like, you gotta go to the bar. If you don't go to the bar, you're gonna lose your job, because it's all about social connections!
Right?
And I freaked out, so blacked out.
Been there, man.
Yeah, but it was worth it.
You know why?
Because I got a promotion.
Yeah.
So what you need to know about these movies for me is that they are critically important to how I view life. And if you, like, I mean, I don't want to, like, exaggerate or anything, but, like, any girl who hasn't gotten these movies, like, she don't get me.
This is 8, right? Fast and the Furious 8?
Yeah, the Fast and the Faturous.
You guys, are you sure I'm not, like, third wheel?
One more time.
No, bro. This is our thing, right? This was originally our thing.
Yeah, it was. So, it was our thing
for a
while.
Now, we're
now there's another person here. So.
I am here. Someone to the thing.
Yep.
Yep.
Hey, kids, you want some sandwiches? It's your dad. Naked and afraid.
You want to keep your eye on Paul Walker.
Great, everyone, welcome to church group.
Oh, you're
yes,
praise
band.
Praise.
Yes.
Praise.
What great Dave Matthews. Oh, Dave. Dave was a man ahead of his time, you know? Why doesn't he have a Grammy?
Say like Jen Johnson.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's a lot of what Christians listen to.
I accidentally brought my shotgun instead of my.
Oh. Oh.
I have one single.
That's right. Jack Johnson this shit.
Yeah, I want to be a musician, and I can. Hard job.
shove shit off.
Who cares?
Yes.
We'll get it done.
HR, you're just checking in.
Oh, hey, dude, what's up?
Kiddo, you too, sport.
Guys, and that's not how Johnsons are. Johnsons are good men. Listen, I know you guys didn't grow up with a woman in the home, but your dad and Uncle Gary here.
Like this, David?
Yeah, David, seriously.
We know we're all going to die.
No, but we don't think about it enough.
Well, just think about this eternal
thing about our flame right here.
John, darling. You know, I have to say, the rays of sunshine above that turtle remind me of our mornings waking up together. Your warm breath on my face.
It's a beautiful scene there. I mean, you wouldn't expect to see such a turtle like out in the prairie like that with nothing else around it. Just that one tree. And I'm sure there's some sort of symbolism behind it, but I'm not as well versed in art as you are. But I mean, to me it's just a turtle and a tree with a tire swing next to it.
The thing that's crazy about that little space, I swear to God, it looks like the Scream mask. Like, am I gonna get murdered? I don't know.
Is the turtle involved?
I don't know. Oh man. Do you know what was sad about that movie? Is the fact that like the boyfriend was such a murderer.
I know.
Sorry, spoiler.
And he took her virginity. Spoilers.
No.
Yeah, he just splashed a boob. But wait, it's been a while since I've seen this.
No.
Was that in Scream 2? No.
Oh, spoiler.
What I can't figure out, I'll be honest with you guys. Sam, Kayla, what I can't figure out is why are there so many dead frogs?
Yeah.
It's like everywhere.
It's like, how do they all die?
Yeah.
Was this like a disease? Like,
well, it's just like Passover with the plague of frogs.
Oh, yeah. Look in the background, all those little dots there, that's the locusts. That's definitely the locusts.
Yeah. Wait, is there no...
Let my people go.
Is there a smear of blood over that tree?
Yeah?
What a creepy baby.
Oh, my God.
Wait, is that olive oil in the lifeguard tower in the corner right there?
No. You know, that's standard issue. That's true to life.
Is that Pluto? Dead on the beach?
Wow, I thought this was an older painting, but clearly it's...
Why does he have spinach coming out of his mouth?
Are you sure that's spinach?
Go ahead, Caleb, say what you're going to say.
Honey, I would never let our baby eat spinach. I would never do that. And I would never let our baby just be at the beach with a big wolf next to it.
Who's suggesting that?
No, boys, I brought you here because if you look, this baby, if you squint, reminds me of when I had you. Juliana!
Yummies?
Why is there so much blood raining from the sky?
Oh. Because of the clouds. The thing that I'm more concerned about, and I recognize the blood, and that's alarming. But equally alarming, if you look closely, both of those clouds look like a two-headed person, and the left side looks
like the horns!
Dan Miller, and the right side looks just like Caleb Sullivan.
The horns! Oh, and with horns!
And it's a Jew-sized cloud.
Oh my God, do these look like us?
I mean, maybe a little, honey, but...
No, this looks weirdly like us.
Sam, I just realized, if you take a step back, the sun, that's actually that little dangling light from like an anglerfish.
Yeah.
It's really freaking me out.
Wait a minute, there's Alex Kasanis' name in the corner. That fucker somehow.
Wait a second.
Why are there shekels on the bottom? And, like, why does it have to be anti-Semitic?
Jeff and Kaylin.
They're both saying yay.
Yay.
There's a little bubble.
Oh, yay.
Says
yay.
In nice big bold block letters.
The thing that I love about this piece of art is that it really gets at the idea of like our politicians honest? Because that Washington Monument is Pinocchio's nose, and it is growing!
That must be why Rosie O'Donnell looks like Sean Spicer.
Is that Barack Obama? Does he have a gold medal for
him? Right, Obama!
Why are the horses so skinny? I don't understand. There are four horses. Horses aren't naturally that skinny. At least they shouldn't be.
I mean, maybe the budget for the film was, you know, didn't have a lot of money to do for
this. Then don't have horses in the movie.
This is like my favorite outtake from a lead in their own horses. It's neither. It's
one of
the things. What I really like is how much detail there is in like the stance in the audience and everything like that. Like, you got the baseball game going on.
God, and they put Obama on water skis. It's like, what, he's a gold medal vacationist?
Oh, I mean,
of course.
Oh, man. That coffee is a swimming pool. That is a cup of coffee that's a swimming pool.
No.
Yes, it is.
Jordan!
I can recognize a coffee cup size swimming pool when I see it. That's it.
To me, it looks like a giant spoon.
Oh, because art's interpretive. I get it.
It's like, what does it look like to you, Nick?
A swimming pool. It actually looks like a real swimming pool.
Just a normal,
yeah,
swimming,
normal
pool.
Swimming pool.
But not with coffee.
Yeah.
Or
not even much it.
So is that it? Sunbathing in that donut?
Yeah. I think he's like using the glaze on the donut to reflect the sun.
That's resourceful.
I think it's interesting how the artist drew a self-portrait of himself in the corner. Himself in the work, very literally.
Yes.
But is, yes, that dog is going to eat the donut, and I feel like he's going to eat the man after.
Definitely going to eat both of them.
He, like, his mouth is so close to that man's arm, and he doesn't even know what's going to happen.
That octopus is having an arm wrestling contest with itself.
I know.
Ate the garlic bread, went home, got busy,
in my house, in my childhood bedroom, my mom walks in, and, well, not after the fact, I was like, it really smells like garlic in here.
This isn't a normal mountain, it's a cool mountain.
Yeah, I can tell from the silhouette. Okay.
Yeah.
And look how cool. It looks like.
Wow. It's super.
So it moves. The tectonic plates are amazing. It looked like it didn't want to look like someone having anal sex with someone else for a second. It's really hard.
Once you climb up here, it'll be cool.
Tell.
Do it.
All right.
Whoa, you're so cool.
You didn't think I had to make it.
I cannot wait to take you to Chubby Wubby. I went here every day when I was a little kid. It was the best place ever. You can just smell it from basically like my mom's house.
So you just came here?
Yeah, I mean, this is what we did in Charleston. Like, every single time, like, we would walk out and you just smell it, and oh, it just feels like home right now.
How'd you fuck?
You're Indiana Jones, aren't you? You are.
I try to hide it. It's the whip, the hat.
Oh my gosh.
Just the coolness. Yeah, that's me.
Wow, I knew it.
Yeah. Oh my gosh.
I have a sense for these things. Like when it's like someone is like some sort of superstar archaeological man, I know all of them.
Can I get you?
Oh man,
I'm
right at the front of the line.
You're in the front of the line here in Chubby
Wubby. Oh man, can I get all of it? Can I get a number one?
That's a whole lot of Chubby Wubbies here.
Can I get a number two also?
Yeah.
I'll make that a
extra
double.
Extra chub?
Yeah, but can I get all
of it? This is the old Chubby.
How long did it take to get a Chubby?
A long time to get a Chubby here.
Chubby.
Oh, so what's up? Wait a minute. You all get Chubbies in time.
I am waiting for Chubby.
I should get a number three with the Diet Coke.
I want my Chubby extra sticky.
Chubby.
Can you demonstrate how to use a cool bathroom?
Oh, sure.
Sex, but that's not cool. So it looks like there's two people having sex as the bathroom.
There's two people in the bathroom. It's just sex.
Thanks for bringing me to your hometown.
Yeah, I mean, I need to stop at the dump every time I'm here and just roll around in the trash. Just
feel it all over me. I came here as a child. Soak it in.
How do people fuck in this city?
Hey.
Hey.
You're Han Solo, aren't you?
That's right.
I just like... You're a Wookiee, aren't you?
Whoa, over here. Solo.
Right. I just, you know, I know I have this sense, like, when people are, like, these cool, like, space scoundrels.
You really got that from me?
Yes.
Oh, what? Oh, my God. Well, this one's all right.
Head first, it looks so fun.
No, don't do that. That's pretty much part of the script.
What?
lost another one.
I'm gonna go see if she's okay.
No, you should have another one. All 60 characters.
Oh, that's great! Am I finally gonna get my big break?
Well, you're gonna be extra number 3, so just don't hurt yourself.
No, I'm so bad! Holy extra number 3!
Oh! No, you're gonna be bruised.
Amazing.
Alright, extras number 1 and 2.
We're just one. We work as together. We're either a mountain or we are a toilet or something. I cannot work without my butt.
No way.
Non-sexual position.
As long as like it's not harmful to
tell us when we're playing.
Okay,
we're
so
good.
You're both axe murderers chasing someone.
We're what?
You're axe murderers chasing someone.
All right.
Hometown sex shop. What an odor. What an odor, huh? What an odor. What do it? Odor. Are any sex toys still in their wrapping?
I'm the owner, and they are.
Oh. And you're the odor.
I'm the owner, and the odor.
Oh. Amazing. Where do people fuck around here?
Are you Harrison Ford?
Yes.
I just have this like thing where I can tell like, you know, like really aged actors that haven't aged into their old age very well, like you're not as attractive.
I'm sorry.
Hey, no one talk to my friend like that.
Fuck you. This is Moldy.
I'm a piece of rock. Big rock. Snakes cannot bite. So...
I'm not a snake.
Want to know how we met?
Yeah, tell their story, buddy.
I love telling our story. I was in this cave. It was not like a cave. It was like a temple. Well, it was like a temple. It was like a...
That's
like a long, man.
I'm sorry, man. It's the best.
Gotten the statue thing, and then I was running, and there's arrows, and I went, and like I threw the arrows, and then it looked like there's a chasm. It wasn't like a chasm, it was like a gap. But I was like trying to jump across. I jumped across. And then.
Yeah.